girl, Brandi. Let me tell you guys something. Please pray for Brandi. This is something serious. I'm going to let you guys know something. Max, he's something else. And let me know what else I told y'all I found out. Max is her husband. I don't know if you guys know these people, but that man is Max. And that girl is Brandi. Now, they used to be on Love and Hip Hop, okay? But let me tell you, the recording, the video leakage I got is something else. You hear, girl, she's screaming for her life. And he's, you know, he's doing some crazy stuff to her. Oh my goodness, how he was yelling at her. How he was kept calling her B this and B that and B that. You trying to tell people about me, B, and calling her all type of MFs and just hearing how she's screaming for her life. Girl, it was something serious and something sad. And I gotta let y'all know what's going on. Everybody is talking about this. And I'm sure tomorrow, everybody gonna be talking about this, all right? And I was looking at Fee, because you know I be going over Fee, Gossip in the City. And she's letting people know, guess what? He's been putting paws on her for years, y'all. And the entire industry knows it, including Ray J. But you know, Ray J, he ain't nothing but a dog. Let's talk about Ray J later, okay? It's videos, a clips of Ray J. He's over here putting his mouth all on Sarah, all on the bad girls. Now, mind you, he's supposed to be this big producer, right? This director, and he's doing this type of inappropriate things with the people that work under him, the girls that work under him. He can't get enough. You know what? I would not be surprised come a couple of years later, it's going to be a number of girls lined up exposing Ray J, talking about how he's inappropriate. All right, so check this out. Oh yeah, I forgot. Please like this video. Please like this video. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel. Gigi, where do you live? You always going live around 3 a.m. It's just the spirit. It's the spirit. The spirit been hitting me. All right. So just let me know if everything is good. It's the spirit, girl. I go on when the spirit hit me. All right, so listen, I'm laughing now, but I'm going to be crying in a minute, okay, because this was really touching. But they said no one even cared because it's been going on for 15 years. So people say in the industry they used for Max putting a pause on Brandi. And that's why they got her on this show acting crazy, because you know every time you see Brandi on the show, she's acting aggressive, and girl, she's getting all that from him. That's how Max be acting. Don't you know when y'all see Brandi, y'all be like, oh my God, you so damn extra, Brandi. That's how he acts in the household. And what she's doing, she's mimicking him in the household. Okay? Yeah, that's what she's doing. She's mimicking him. And I guess she got that syndrome, don't you know? When you love the person that putting paws on you, you know, you can't, you love them, you can't get away from them. She's always protecting him, and she gonna protect him tonight. Tonight she came out and she protected him. And girl, I was so mad at her for doing that, but we're gonna talk all about it. But it says here, he has access to all of her devices. They've been doing this for 15 years. He got access to all her devices. So those posts on hers, it's him. He always has her phone. She's not going anywhere. He knows it. They've been together for 17 years now. Okay, so I'm gonna play the clip. Now, if you guys ready for me to play the clip, please press 5. If y'all ready for me to play this clip, when I tell you guys it is triggering, so I just want to let you guys know, if you know, if certain things trigger you, you may not want to watch it because it's very deep, okay? So press 5 when y'all want me to play. And let me tell y'all what else we got to talk about. Lil Baby and that Jayda, because we've been talking about Jayda this whole week. So I've been warming y'all up to let y'all know who Jayda is, who's Ari, okay? Because those the main popular girls on social media. All right, so I'm going to play the clip. Bam, y'all ready for this? Check this out. Now, you know I have to... DJ, please cut that beat. Damn, DJ. Now, you know I had to cut some of the cussing Because Max, he got a temper. I'm scared of Max. His temper, all through the video. Be this, be this, be this, be this. MF of this, MF of this, be this. It's so disturbing. And mind you, in front of the kids, girl. In front of the kids. Yeah. In front of the kids. But let's play. Mm-hmm.
Say here I got it. Say here I got it if you got it. I shall fucking come back. This nigga bitch that you just wanna ask. How the fuck you wanna ask me? I'm not down for it. Fuck you. I'm fucking going away. You got that thing on my head yet? You got that thing on my head yet?
Girl, I can't stand it. Okay, so he's grabbing her by the head, right? Uh-huh, pushing her face down. Well, she can't even talk, all right? And he's saying, I'm not down with your program. You got that through your thick head, B? You got that through your head, B? Kept on calling her B, a female dog, all right? Yeah, but tomorrow he gonna say, I love you. You know, I ain't mean to do that, girl. This been going on. This has been going on. He's been putting her on that show to be so aggressive and loud and crazy. Yeah, that's the act that they want her to play. And, she needs help her damn self. You know what I mean? Because clearly she has low self-esteem. And guess what? After all this, she gonna come back and defend that man like she always do. I don't believe her, but let's continue on, okay? Check this out.
You got that thing on me? I'm not with your program. Fuck off of me. Get out of here.
Girl, I don't know if you can hear, but you can hear in a low key. That's what I heard. She said, she talking to her kid. Never again. You ain't gonna have to see daddy put paws on me. Never again. You gonna see him put paws on me. She's talking to her kids, right? And he's saying, bye, B. Throughout this whole thing, she's all B's and all MF's. It's a dang shame, you know? Because this goes on all the time. This ain't nothing new in that household, you know? No wonder why certain girls cannot stand up for other girls, because they getting called bees and disrespected, so they think that stuff is normal, you know? Girl, let's get back.
Never again will you
fuck
you heard what he said?
Bye, bitch.
Hold on. Get out of here, B. Bye, B. Kept on calling her a B. Kept on, that lets you know how he really feel about your butt, you know? Disrespecting you, calling you a female dog. Not even a human, but a female dog, all right? You know, he said, get out my face. Check this out.
Goodbye.
In front of the kids, too, girl. Have no respect for the kids. You know, the kids may be young, but it's still trauma, you know? And it's sad. It's sad. And ain't he the man? Ain't he supposed to be the leader? Ain't he supposed to be the household? You know what I mean? But look how he doing his house. I can't stand it. And she gonna come out and defend him. Yeah. You know, she's gonna come out. She's gonna take accountability. Talking about some, I put the pause on him. I was doing everything to him. And, you know, he was just talking reckless to me because I was talking reckless to him first. Ain't no excuse. It's no excuse. No excuse. Nah. So what y'all equal? The strength of the woman is the same strength of a man? Is that what you're saying? We're going to continue to play. Girl, she's out here trying to get people to help her because she getting putting paws on her. And he's saying, oh, you going to disrespect me, huh? You going to disrespect me to Ronnie? Tell him, Ronnie, I'm putting paws on you? So he see it as a form of disrespect if she's going to get help for herself. She can't get help for herself. She don't even belong to herself. She belongs to him. You his ass property. she don't have no value, no self-worth for herself. She gets on a post and defend him because that's what he wants. She don't have no say-so. She don't even belong to herself. She done sold her soul to a man. How about that? Now, y'all talking about selling souls to the Hollywood? You have a lot of girls out here that sell their own soul to a man. Yes, they do. Woo-wee. So anytime she's going out here telling people, he sees it as a form of disrespect. You disrespecting him by running your mouth telling anybody. And this stuff been going on. It's been going on. Girl, it's too much. I can't just play it all. It's too much. So he's saying, you hear, Brandi? You gonna disrespect me to the world, Brandi? Girl. And I'm sure he got both of his hands, you know, putting hands around her neck, just going downtown with her. This ain't the first time. This ain't the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, the sixth. He always do her ass like that. Yes, he does. You know what it remind me of? The Color Girls. Yes, it does. Do you remember the Color Girls and that man that was putting paws on that girl and she was so sweet and she worked for Janet Jackson? And then at the end of it all, he ended up putting them kids out the window and the neighbors was here. Girl, guess what? You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to play a clip from the Color Girls, and I want you guys to see what I'm talking about, okay? Check this out.
You still fine. Strong. Did you get right back up? That time you had that little fight, you went right back to work?
Woo! You see how they do? All right, so her nose, you know, got the red all on it, girl, you know, because he just got finished putting the paws on her. And he said, you still fine. Yeah, that's what they'll do to you. Let me tell you, they'll black your eye and say, you so beautiful. You still fine, you know? You know? Go on, get up there. Yeah, they like when you down and out. They like when you looking messed up. Yeah, they don't want nobody else looking for you or checking for you. But he said, go on, you get back to work. You so strong. Ain't that messed up? Ain't that messed up? I'm going to keep on playing.
You gotta get help, Bo.
You gonna marry me?
Damn it, Bo, no. I'm not.
Girl, why you say that? But you know what? She was being honest. He said, are you gonna marry me? And what do we, how often do we talk this week about when you reject these men? They can't take it. The ego? She rejected. She said, no, she's not going to marry him. He needs to get help. What's wrong with that? She's still there. She's still faithful. She just want him to get help, right? Because you know upstairs. But let's keep on playing.
I'm going to marry you. But the babies can't keep seeing their mama like this.
Now, mind you, the same with this situation with Brandi. And Max, how he's putting paws on her in front of all them kids. The same situation happened here in the Summer Girls, or the Color Girls, when he was putting paws on her. And he do it all the time in front of the kids. He don't care. And I'm sure Max be putting paws on her in front of the kids. They don't care. They don't care. They don't.
Your kids. So what you trying to say? They ain't mine?
Look at them trying to pick a fight. Any little thing, they gonna always trying to pick a fight. I'm sure Max always pick little fights with her. You see how he was talking to her. Oh, so you gonna call them folks? Oh, you gonna tell Max you trying to disrespect me by calling Max? It's not about you. It's about trying to get help for her. You can't see that? You can't see you're hurting her? And on top of that, in front of the kids. Girl, bye. Let me go here. Girl. Don't it sound similar? Now let's play. Let's go back to the Max and this Brandi situation. Please like this video and subscribe. Uh-huh. It needs to be talked about because so many people out here, some of our own party crashes is going through this situation now.
You're not! You're not!
Call 911, Brandon.
You're not.
Woo! She said, call 911, Brandon. All right? I don't know if it's other people there or she's on a second phone, but he's yelling at her. He is mad at her. All because she's tired of him putting paws on her and she wants to tell somebody to help her. When she calls for help, he sees it as a form of disrespect. You know? Pretty much blame yourself. You know, you got a black eye, blame yourself. Your feelings hurt, blame yourself. I cuss you out, blame yourself. I put paws on you, don't say I did. You better say you put paws on me. You know, make me seem like a victim and you the one that got the problems. And then let's blame it on the devil. Yeah. We don't believe in taking accountability of ourselves. Let's just blame it on something else, right? Uh-huh. Girl, it is sick. It is sick, sick, sick. You hear that? He kept on calling her B. Can you imagine? Now, she's not disrespecting him. Did you ever hear her call him a B? Or a low-down, dirty dog. She's not back-talking him. This whole video, she is trying to get help. Trying to get help. And she said he put paws on my lip. Her lip is busted. Now, I'm sure she's going to do whatever she can to put some ice on them lips, to take some pills, to put some makeup on his lips, to come on video to try to prove to people to say, see, he ain't do nothing to me. He ain't, girl, we seen this act before. You ain't nothing different. We seen this act before plenty of times of our aunties, our sisters, getting put paws on them and then they turn around, defend a man and act like they all happy and everything is perfect, just like that comedian girl. Didn't we just got finished talking about that comedian girl, how that comedian man was putting paws on her and how she came out to her family acting like everything was fine and everything was the nice sliced bread? Girl, we've seen this act before. You can't fool us, Brandi. We know you're lying. Because let me tell you, she going to put up a post right here and she going to defend him. But let's play.
Call me some bitch. I'll fuck you up, bitch. Woo! Brandi, I'm getting beat up, bitch. Fuck you up, bitch. I'm gonna send you out on a good one, bitch.
Woo! You heard him? He said, I'm gonna F you up, B. He said, Ronnie, he was making fun of a Ronnie. I need help. He said, yeah, call 911. I'm gonna send you out on a good one. Meaning he gonna send her out on a stretcher. And I'm sure she is probably begging for her life. Please, please, I'm sorry. I take it back. Baby, I write that it was my fault. Please, please, please. No, 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 please. Because you know how she can get, right? And I do feel that love in hip-hop, it was all to try to put her up to be this crazy, aggressive maniac. And I don't even know if that's really her for real. I don't know. But girl, I got this from Gossip in the City. Okay? Yes, Miss Fee, she be having a tea. Yes, she does. Okay? So what y'all think about that? So let me get the... So after this video came out and it was leaked out, she came out with a post. Brandi, right? So let's look back on Brandi. Here we go. She came out with a post. I'm going to try to put it up here, attach it. I have to take out all the cuss words out. Where that Brandi at? Brandi. Bam. Here we go. See it right here? I'm going to scroll this up. She says, listen, y'all, I'm fine. He didn't touch me. I was putting paws on him. And I was putting paws on him. You know, she said she was fighting him all he did was verbally abuse me back. She lying. And y'all right. You know, some of these females do lie. Just like this one right here. Brandi, she's lying. She's always lying for him. Yeah. Some of these females, just like Brandi doing, she's lying for that man. That man made her do this. Or he probably typed this up himself. She lying. She lying. It says, me back, I'm sorry for going live. I did that to force us to take a space knowing he wouldn't want to argue on live. Please pray for my family. The devil is attacking so strong. All right, so that was her message. Oh, yeah, she lying. She lying. Uh-huh. Don't you know how people want to say, you know, some of these girls lie. She's one of them, you know. It's a lot of girls that lie to protect these men. Yes, they do. They love to lie to protect these men. Yes, they do. What y'all think about that? What y'all think? Please put it in the comment section. Let us know what you guys think, because I got some more. Yes, I do. I do got some more. But before I continue on, let's give a big thank you. Let me scroll back up here. Man, I didn't see it, but moderators, if you know who gave $5, please let us know again so I can give them a thank you. Thank you so much. All right, so this is Brandi and Max, right? So we got some more output on it. I want you guys to see what the people are saying on Twitter. So this is what the people are saying on Twitter. All right, let's take this out. They are saying, if you know her address, send it to me immediately on this page, right? That's Fee. You know, that's Gossip in the City. Damn, OMG. This don't sound like Max, though. People saying that most definitely sound like Max. He's a pit bull looking behind. What they say? Sound just like him. So people are saying it sound just like him. You know, people are saying he high on them sugar boogers. That Max, he love to stay on them sugar boogers. All right, so let's go here. So this is Max. This is his page. And I guess he's trying to convince you guys that everything is okay. He says, y'all worried about my family? Y'all, men are retarded? Now, why they gotta be retarded? You know? If somebody have concern, now Max, clearly Max, he's out of touch. Because anybody that heard that audio, they heard you put your paws on him. They heard Brandi talking about you ain't gonna never have to see daddy put paws on mama ever again. You know, we heard the cry. But that just let you know how far gone he is, because he knew what he did. Now he's coming on acting like that never happened. Talking about some y'all worried about my family and calling people retarded. You know, that's, first of all, you shouldn't call nobody the R word. I thought we got rid of the R word 5 years ago, you know. Respect to mental health and mental, you know, challenging people. But anyway, he said, you ain't worried about my kids, people. I take care of my family. Yes, yeah, you got a way of taking care of your damn family, okay? Putting paws on them. My wife free to do what she want to do, so F off. World, don't nobody take care of my family but me. We eat. He said, go eat a D. Fake news. I was mad. I was tripping. But ain't nobody. Something. So basically, he's saying all y'all hearing is fake. He said, go eat on some D's. He said, Brandi, she can do whatever she want to do. But we know that ain't the case. You know, he's up here just lying, looking what the people got to say. They said, it's an old video. So basically, the recording that we just replayed, that's a new video. But this video that he's putting out here with his kids, this is an old video. So people is trying to say, like, you know, he's trying to put it out here like he's at the store at the moment taking care of his kids. And that ain't the case. So people say you buy food doesn't mean you're not abusive, you know. You don't care about your family. You are putting paws on your wife in front of the kids. Narcissist vibes. guilt eating him up. All right, so let's keep on going on. Let's keep on going on. Hold on. We ain't there yet. All right, so you got more to say? It says, men never tell how to run my stuff. We're full blown with the business. You get the scope quick. Now listen, y'all gonna have to read this for y'all damn self because I can't understand what he's saying. Okay, first off, y'all ain't hit nobody. First off, he said he ain't put paws on nobody. You lame MFs. Second, I pop stuff in my crib whenever the F I feel like it. Okay, my 17-year-old relationship, Eda D, chat ninjas. You wasn't here from the jump, so fall back. So why is he so mad? You know why he cussing up a storm? You know, he's showing his true colors. It said, everybody in my house, safe every night, suck a D. What is up with him and these D's? I mean, if he tells somebody to eat a D or suck a dick one more goddamn time, ain't nobody thinking about no goddamn D. We thinking about your fist, okay? And how your hands need to be cut off because you don't know how to take care of your hands. You keep on putting it on this little girl, you know? She is, what, 5 times smaller than you? What type of guy put paws on his wife? This is somebody you swear you love? You know, he kept on bringing up the damn D. You know, you infatuated with some dick? What the fuck? Maybe you need to go eat some D. It's how about that? Maybe you need to go suck on a D. You keep on telling everybody else to do it. So, he says, looking for a story. My chick ain't never had one black eye. Y'all is baseless. I'm sure she had a whole bunch of black eyes, but I'm sure over the years, she probably put that avocado on her eyes. She probably got some pills, got that expensive cream. She know how to do it. She know how to cover up. Just like Emily B. Remember Emily B got them teeth busted out by Fabulous? He seemed like the same way. Boy, I tell you. All right. So, Now, what's that? I think this the same video. I'm scared to play this version. Oh, no, they cut it off. And they probably took it off because it was so explicit. I know when I went to Gossip in the City, they didn't even have the video on, you know? So what do y'all think about that? What do y'all think? I'm going to try to find the other video. Nope, this video ain't playing. Nope. Check this out. Hold on. I want to see something real quick. Just give me 1 second. I want to see the Shade Room. Do the Shade Room got that video? And usually, the Shade Room, they'll cut certain things out. Damn. I guess tonight ain't my night because I can't even get to the damn Shade Room. All right, well, we just going to have to leave that alone. I'm going to look in the comment section, see what you guys got to say. All right, it says, I feel y'all know as well. I'm crying to laugh that he be putting paws on her. I mean, that's nothing to laugh about. I bet he was stopped down to a real man. I wanted to see the video before the black screen. I think he's a producer. What the hell is it even about? I'm lost. It's a control mechanism. I finally caught you live. Yeah. So I was trying to find. You know what? I did download it. I can play. I did download it. Okay, so y'all want to hear the uncut version? The version that I did not cut out. I don't know. It may be too much. Let me see.
I got it. Say, yeah, I got it. Say, yeah, I got it if you got it, bitch. I ain't your motherfucking clumsy ass, goofy ass nigga, bitch, that you just wanna act how the fuck you wanna act with. I'm not down for it, bitch. Fuck you. And fuck that boy later. You got that through your motherfucking head yet? You got that thing out of there yet?
Girl! Oh, hell. That ain't the uncut virgin either. You know, I don't know where that goddamn virgin at. Oh, you know what it is? It would be in my downloads, right? But no, I don't see it. I don't see it. Oh, I know what I did. Oh, you know what? How about this? If we go up here, bam, that's where I got it from right here. I forgot I went up here. This is where I got it from, right up here. I don't know why she didn't put it on her Instagram, but.
I got it. Say, yeah, I got it if you got it, bitch. I ain't your motherfucking clumsy ass, goofy ass nigga, bitch, that you just wanna act how the fuck you wanna act with. I'm not down for it, bitch. Fuck you, and fuck that boy with you. You got that through your motherfucking head yet? You got that through your head yet? You got that through your head, bitch? I'm not with your program. Fuck off with me. Be out of here, bitch.
Last time y'all seen him beat on me, y'all gonna have to see me ever again. I promise you, man. Never again will you see me beat on.
Bye, bitch.
Did y'all hear that part? She said, never again would you have to see your mama get beat on. And that's the same thing that girl and the color girls was saying. Remember when she was saying that she don't want her kids to see her get the paws put on her? I'm going to rewind it back. All right, check this out. Listen good now. Listen good.
Y'all see her beat on me, y'all. You're
going
to have to see me ever again. I promise you, man.
Never again will you see
mama
get beat on.
Bye, bitch. Goodbye. Good motherfucking bye. You're gonna stop fucking with me. Ronnie, don't call me. I'm getting beat up. You gonna disrespect me to Ronnie too, bitch? You think you're gonna disrespect me to the world, Brandi? Is that what you think? You're not!
Girl, listen, I had to cut it off. It'd be too much, all right? I get triggered sometime, okay? I do. All right? It'd be too much. You know, I tried to do the unvirgin cut or whatever you want to call it. I didn't hurt enough. I don't want to have to keep on hearing this. Like watching a damn scary movie over and over again. I'm going to have nightmares. And I don't want no damn nightmares. So what y'all think? Okay? What y'all think about that? You know? What y'all think about this? Ain't that something? You never know what people's going through. You never know. I think it's the sugar boogers. I don't know what it is. His voice scared me. Shout out me too, Z. Shout out to the Z. It's a girl that's a scary movie. A divorce, but they said she's not going to get divorced. I already told you what Fee said. Let me go here. I told you what Fee put up, and Fee be knowing everything. Look, she says he been putting a pause on her for years, y'all, and the entire industry knows it. That Ray J know it. But you know these men is not going to say nothing to their homeboys that putting a pause on these black girls or these girls. They not going to say nothing. They ain't. And they know these girls can't defend themselves. You know? She ain't no match for him. And y'all crazy if you think she is. No one even cared because it's been going on for 15 years. So she used to it. She used to protecting him and taking up for his ass. He has access to all her devices. So those posts aren't even hers. So basically she's saying that he is the one that's typing everything. Because he got the password. He got access to everything. He's very controlling. He also has her phone. She's not, remember when that comedian man, he took her phone too. So you see a pattern, right? She's not going anywhere and he know it, okay? They've been together for 17 years now. They dragged her for putting pause on him on the show. But I think that show was an act. They just want, they forced her to be aggressive and loud. But I think she was mimicking how he is in the household. You know, I really do. I think that's how he is. Because usually men that's like to put paws on you, they want you to act the fool in public so people can get the idea that you aggressive, so people can think that you the troublemaker. If they can make you look like a fool in front of the people, so people can feel bad for them, like, dang, man, you such a good man. You deal with all that stuff from her, and you still loyal, and you still love her. That's what they want. They always want to be the victim. They can't stand when you make them guilty, you know? They can't stand when you make them accountable. And you see, she put the post up, you know, even though some people feel like it's he did it. She put the post up. Why didn't he come up and he wasn't accountable? You see, this post, it reads, it was all her fault. She said, I'm fine. He didn't touch me. I was the one that was putting paws on him. I was the one that was verbally, you doing this to him, you know? She said, I'm sorry. Did he ever say he's sorry in them posts? Nope. He was calling, he was telling everybody to suck a D or eat some D's. He was so consumed with dick, you know? I don't know what he got, his obsession with the D word, but that's all he would say. Suck a D, eat a D, suck a D, eat a D. I got tired of it. So that's his favorite words, D, the B word, and MF. So it says, I guess going live, I did that to force us to take a space, knowing he wouldn't want to argue on live. So I guess she's trying to put it like, you know, I did that to force him so we can argue on live. Nah, that was some real stuff, boo. You know, you ain't that good of an actress, okay? She can't act that good. All right, let's give it up for Cheerful Hollow, donating $3. Who is this couple? This is Brandi and Max. You guys probably know them for the Love and Hip Hop. They was on Love and Hip Hop for a while. Please play the retired recording. There are women in here going through the same situation, but don't believe it. It would be bad. Play it all. Now, I can't play it all because it's explicit. I played most of it, and that's all I'm going to do. I'm not going to be forced to play it all because it just get worse. He just keep on screaming at her and yelling at her and calling all types of bees, you know? So he don't want the video out. I think he wrote that. That's what everybody's saying. They think he wrote it, you know? That's what everybody's saying. So let's go here. So we see here, this the shade room. Finally got to the shade room. So people in the shade room, look at this. They says he definitely made her say that because she said it be the last time he put paws on her, all right? I told y'all in the video, she was saying that's the last time you're going to see Daddy putting paws on mommy. That's what she was saying to the kids because the kids was reacting to him putting paws on her. So it says, nah, officer, that house right there. Please don't judge her for lying. Okay, so don't judge her for lying. And I do agree with that because, you know, she something wrong with her clearly. You know, she's not in her right frame of mind. Who would be in a right frame of mind if somebody's been enslaved for 17 years of abuse? You're not in your right frame of mind. So I can't fault her. Let's give a big thank you to Cheerful Hollow for donating $3. Did you check your Cash App? I did not. Not yet. But I'm going to. Thank you so much. All right. So let me keep on going on. Please don't judge her. No one knows what's going on. Just pray for her and her safety. This sounds forced. It was forced. Because right after that video went leaked, right? That's soon you saw that, you know? And like I said, if she get on video, they going to probably try to put some makeup on her to make sure she look fine. She probably going to have to get on video, try to force it like, hey, y'all. I'm doing fine. I'm out here in Hollywood buying these purses or whatnot. You know, she gonna have to sell it. So Max gave that, Max, get that lady her phone back. He wrote that because she clearly said on the live to her kids, the last time y'all gonna see me get beat on. Woo! I did not tell y'all that. I told y'all that. Y'all gonna hear me today. I know what I heard. You can hardly hear it because he's over talking her. He's over talking her, calling her all types of B's and MFs. Let's give a big thank you to Corey. Always coming through. Corey, you always blessing us. Corey just donated $10 to the Cash App Pink Lips 500. Thank you, Corey. We appreciate that. Thank you, Corey. All right, so let's keep on moving on. I'm going to look in the comment section before I move on. Let me see. They say she going to be on live with a damn Birkin bag. Maybe, because you know how these men are. You see how Fabulous do and all these other men. They'll buy them expensive stuff, and she's not in the right frame of mind. So Monice tried to warn. Really? So y'all telling me Monice told homegirl and was telling people that he put paws on her? I never knew. Brandi, Ray J cousin, she was the one that kept all of Ray J's secrets. And you wonder why, because I'm sure she's keeping so many secrets in his household. And I'm sure she's embarrassed. You know, these girls go through so much, y'all. They go through so much. Where can we see or hear the full version when I interrupt? You know what? How about this? Go to Twitter. Go to Gossip in the City. How about that? Okay. Gossip in the City. It say Brandi be husband. Oh, hell. Girl. Y'all gonna get me kicked off. See, I didn't want to put the K word. You see what it said about the take her out of here, you know? So go to what it say, fee with the T. Go to fee with the T. All right. Now I'm gonna keep on moving on, because like I said, around this story, it's a whole bunch of certain words I don't want to put on here. And it's a lot of stuff going on. All right. So I'll be trying to keep it cute. So let's keep on moving on. They not related. Birkin bags, the little baby. Right, baby was always on. So she's tiny. Why would he ever? I don't think they care how small you are. You know, they don't care. You know, I think probably the smaller you are, the more they're going to put paws on you. The more they feel like they can scare you. The more they feel like they can control you, the smaller you are, I'm guessing. So let's move on here, okay? So you see the mean girls, right? So that's exactly what we're dealing with today. The mean girls, another chapter. These are the mean girls right here. And we're going to talk about Jayda. Jayda, she's wearing purple. Now, the meanest girl, her name is Ari. She's wearing, what's that kind of, a deep red? And then you have Dreamed Out, right? Now, to me, they remind me of the Mean Girls. Gretchen is in the middle. Gretchen is Ari. Georgina is Ari. And then Jayda is Gretchen. Because Gretchen, she was known for always liking expensive stuff. And all she cares about is name brand. And she's pretty and all and whatnot, you know. And then you have Dreamed Out, which I think is definitely a Karen, because Karen in the movie, she always cared about her body and her boobs, and she was known to be a hoe. Don't they remind you of the Mean Girls? And that's why I think they're so damn popular, you know. And they sitting all in the right space. Ari's in the middle. Jada's at the end with the checker dot sweater. And Dreamed Out is over there, right there. Let's go keep on going. So that's sad about Dreamed Out can't talk about nobody. Yeah, but you know, Dreamed Out really don't be in the news much, only if she's messing around with somebody. But this ain't nothing new. So, you know, a post, it shows Lil Baby and Jayda has unfollowed each other, but they say they've been unfollowing each other, so it's nothing new. Right. However, you know, they always together. We know that Jayda really wants this relationship to work. And Jayda, she's one of the flyest girl on social media. She always got the latest name brand. She got a lot of money. She's pretty. A lot of girls, you know, flock to her, want to be like her, right? So it was a whole bunch of stuff going on. So her boyfriend, her man or whatever, Lil Baby, he was caught. Well, he wasn't caught. The adult star decided to leak information about him doing the stuff with it. Damn. Lord, it's the thumbnail. You know, people don't know how to put clothes on and they got damn thumbnail. Here we go. It says, not dropping no names, but Jayda, not leaving this man ever, okay? She said, the best D I've ever had can come from a millionaire who didn't say no more than two full sentences to me. He literally beat me to the mattress soon as I got in the room. I legit about to talk all night. So basically, she's bragging about it. She said she's gonna talk all night about it. So he paid her $16,000 to have his fantasies come true. A lot of people are saying, why are you paying an adult star to do it with? I think because he probably watch adult films, and these guys see women like cars. You know how you got your favorite car, but then you see a car on TV and you're like, man, I want to test drive that car too, you know, and I want to try that car too. So that's how they see girls' damn properties, right? So she got a price and he probably was looking at her videos and he wanted his fantasy to come true. He probably always daydreamed and probably was a fan of hers. And he wanted his the video to come true. That's what I think. So let's keep on going here. It says, it's good. I'm never gonna get it again. My publicist has confirmed that I messed up before I even got into the house. I made a mistake and I'm logging off. I was wasted. So basically she said she made a mistake. She was talking too much. And she should not have said what she said. But then she goes on and she continued to talk, right? She says, new video, and the one is popular. He know damn well he shouldn't have let me record us. So basically, London is saying that she got recordings of him and her doing a do. Yeah, she said she got recordings. She said he allowed it too. But like I said, I feel like the baby was a fan of Miss London. And, you know, some of these guys, their fantasy is to be an adult star, you know. They watch him all the time. Mm-hmm. And so maybe he didn't have no problem with that because he didn't care. So look at here. It says, so the baby, let me go here. The baby then paid Miss London $16K to F. Why? When you got a girl... Damn, when you got a girl who body just as bad and just paid $200K for a watch, ? And what do you guys think? Why do you feel that the Brady and Ray J and all these celebrities pay top dollar to mess with girls when they have a wife at home? What do you guys think? Comment, let us know. That girl gets sued. He should have gave them the 16 to Jayda. But, that's not the baby. Well, little baby, y'all know who I'm. Goddamn. Little baby. Mm-hmm. Little baby. I'm talking about little baby. You see the pictures. Mm-hmm. I wish they would have changed their name to something totally different. So it says the baby cheated on Jayda with Miss London. But some people may say he didn't cheat. It was a business transaction, you know. Do you guys see it as a cheating or do you see it as business? Because there was just not doing to do. It was business. She did get paid. Can someone explain this? Little baby slash real. Miss London thing to me. Nah, I ain't gonna explain shit, okay? So y'all see it here. Let's go here. So the baby is responding. He says, like, huh? What the F be wrong with y'all people? I get it. Say my name and get clout. Y'all really need to stop. It's desperate. So basically, at first, he was pretty much saying that, nah, this ain't true. People just say my name for clout, you know? Did y'all believe him? What y'all think? All right, so let's keep on going on. So when Jayda heard the news, she got on social media and she pretended to be unbothered, you know? So this is her being unbothered after she heard the news that the baby was out doing it with somebody else. Now, mind you, I think they was on a vacation. They was out. I think they was in Vegas. And he decided to do this in Vegas. It's almost, don't you know how Princess and Ray J went to Vegas, right? And Princess had her baby. But Ray J didn't come back to the room that night. And Princess felt that Ray J left her. But Ray J was really at a different hotel in different rooms being with different women, right? That's what we find out. So it's the same thing that happened here. Jayda and Lil Baby, they went to Vegas. And the baby ended up paying, I guess, an adult star. And she didn't keep her mouth closed. She came out about it. I hear a lot of adult stars are mad at her because you're giving everybody else in that industry a bad name. They always sleep with married men. They always sleep with celebrities. It ain't nothing new. But they pay for you to keep your mouth closed and be discreet, you know? And I do feel like the freaky girl, she's wrong for that. You got to keep your mouth closed, boo. It ain't even worth it, you know? So anyway, this is Jayda.
Y'all, we all drunk. We're supposed to be at the jet place right now. Baby's still fucking gambling. I stopped because I won and I said I'm done. Y'all, we all.
Damn. I'm tired of seeing that damn picture.
Yeah, we are.
I am tired of seeing that picture. I'm tired of seeing that picture. All right, so the girl, she come back speaking, you know. This is, what's her name? The London girl. So it says, this money and fame stuff trenches. I never wanted to lose or hurt or disrespect myself in it. That's why I remove myself from it. And I'm certain happy stuff ain't been done to me regardless of the benefits, all right? My only N plus is don't be willing to give these men one night of selling your cat more than you're willing to supply your own child to eat with them in a month. So basically she's saying the reason why she costs that high is because how much he pays for child support, that's how much she's gonna charge. Listen, girl, get your money, you know? Charge his ass 20K if you want to, you know, because these girls, these high professional girls in London, they definitely get top dollar pay, you know. That 16K ain't nothing compared to the high top girls that's in London in America. Oh, they get paid. Mm-hmm. So it says, call me bitter all you want. I don't make sense to me, and I'm speaking from a place of not giving a F what a man do with his thingy thing. So basically she says she really don't care what that man do. It's all about the money for her. It's business. So girl always got to find a way to involve herself. That little boy is literally gets the newest iPhones, iPads. Mm. Oh, hold on. This ain't the... Listen, all these hoes starting to look alike, okay? This the baby mama. This the baby mama, okay? Listen, I thought this was London still talking, okay? This is the baby mama, and the baby mama, she got something to say. Mm-hmm. It says, this money and fame I never wanted to lose respect or hurt. So this the baby mama talking. Let me scroll on up here. Yep. So it says little baby. Says little baby, baby mama. Damn, that's a lot of babies. Says that the money could have went to his son. So basically she said instead of going to the adult star, it should have went to his son, you know. But these men see adult stars and girls like they do expensive cars, like they do game systems. They just have fun with them. It's a game. They like to have fun. So that's just what it is. I'm looking in the comment section. All right. So let's keep on moving on. So he responds. It says, when stuff going good, watch for the devil. All right, that's his response to it. She posted, now we're back to London, which is an adult star. And this is what she says. She says she is posting up text messages of the baby responding to her messy self, you know, going viral with it. It says the point of pen if you gonna do all that, okay? You effing the game up. If I pay for your cat, you don't supposed to speak on it, okay? That's bad business. So basically he said, listen, if I'm paying for you, you don't talk about it. You don't go on social media. This is bad business. Why would you do me like this? All right, when you out on some demonish. So I'm looking in our comment section. He needs to watch that damn self. If he paying his child to support on top of that, spending time with his child, why should he need to spend that money on his son? She just wanted more money for him. And you know how certain people, they don't like the idea these girls is getting paid so much money. A lot of people don't like adult stars, you know, because they be sleeping with everybody man, and they man be paying them a lot of money, but they don't even spend that much money on a wife. They don't spend that much money on their kids, but they'll spend it on an adult star. They're spending on these girls like this. I guess their fantasy, they're spending on their fantasy. So anyway, Regine, she seemed to chime in, so people was talking about that. It says, reverse psychology is a sickness, in my opinion, because B, you wrong. So people got at her. People said, wait, sis, I know you ain't talking about this situation, right? So Regine said, what situation you talking about? When I tweet, it's about me, myself, and I ain't speaking on nobody. I have no clue about it. Remember this, all right? So people are saying that she was talking about Jada's situation. You know, she picked a fine time to chime in. What y'all think about that? Hold on. Let's give a big thank you to Real Mama. Donating $5. Watching from work. Much love. Thank you for the tea. Well, thank you so much, Real Mama. We appreciate it. I really do. All right. So let's keep on going here. It was just too much. So it says, Jada, been with me my whole time. My whole birthday, including Vegas. Y'all be on some bull crap. So he's pretty much saying that Jada and him been together that whole weekend, including the Vegas trip, that you guys are tripping. It's a lie. He didn't do anything with her. He doesn't know her. Leave him alone. And the baby, that's what it seemed. He wants to be with Jada, right? But he wants an open relationship. He wants to be able to be with different women on the side. And he want to be a free man, right? But Jada, she wants to give off this idea that she got everything together. She got the expensive cars. She got the money. She got the top man. And she has a nice, great life. You know, her man that she loves is not cheating on her. That's what she tries to give, but he keeps messing that fantasy up when he keeps getting caught, because this ain't the first time he getting caught, you know. The baby has gotten caught time and time before. She always go through this. This ain't nothing new. So that's why people are saying it doesn't matter because she ain't going nowhere. And you know what I start thinking about? Because Jayda, she's always into designer clothes, just like Gretchen. Gretchen, she was the girl that was known with expensive purses and the top thing. Sometimes I think certain people see their relationship as a Chanel bag and like the new Gucci bag. So Lil Baby, he's one of the top rappers at this time. So I don't know if she sees him as like an accessory. Like, this my Gucci bag. This my new Chanel bag. Everybody want the baby. Lil Baby. And I cannot afford to not be with him. You know? It's part of her collection. You know? Because why would she continue to be with this man after he done embarrassed your ass time and time again? You know? Unless y'all just be in an open relationship. But, I think they are in an open relationship, honestly. But anyway, let's keep on going on. It says, this is Jayda. This is her talking. She says, trying to F up the brand, you bad for business. All right? So people are saying, I hope you're not defending Lil Baby. She says, F no, she's not. All right? So she won't let you guys know she ain't defending him. I'm tired of seeing that damn picture. All right, so she got some more stuff to say. It says, see, this is why it's best to just shut the F up and just chill. Because as soon as you show a little bit of happiness on the internet, MFs be like, oh, nah, I'm so tired of this stuff. So basically she said, y'all seen Lil Baby and Jayda having a good time, kissing on each other, being cuddle butter on the internet, and as soon as she does that, then you're gonna have these girls coming out trying to make it seem like, you know, I got a piece of your man. She feel like the girl coming out sideways was a dig to Jayda. She feel like it really don't have nothing to do with the baby. It really was a dig to her, because the girl came out talking about some I know Jayda ain't gonna never leave him. The D was so good. So she feel like these girls are just jealous. And it was really a dig to her, you know. And I guess looking back at it, I guess I can see where she's coming from, especially when the girl came out. And the girl was like, I know Jayda ain't gonna never leave that D. That D so good. I ain't even talked to him for 2 minutes and he just smashed me to smithereens, you know. So, possibly. Because clearly, he didn't want to have an intimate relationship with her. He wasn't talking to her. He was just there for the thrill. And these guys, they like the thrill of it. You know, you may say, well, I give the best head and I give the best this and that. That's fine. But guess what? They still gonna want variety. They are curious as hell. They always gonna be curious about the next person. You can be a wife with the best, whatever you wanna call yourself. But if a man is a cheater, and he always going to be curious about what the next girl got to offer. And he want to experience that. And he can't control his lust. He can't control his flesh. He's always want a taste of something else. You know, they want a buffet. They want a variety. They want some chicken, some fried chicken, some lemon chicken, you know, some barbecue chicken, you know. They want a goddamn variety. And I think with him, it's like Jayda. You know you got my heart. I care about you. But this dang-a-lang, it's going to be for everybody, you know? I cannot control how I feel with my thing. And I don't feel like I should control it. I'm making a lot of money. I'm enjoying myself. And I should enjoy myself with giving my thing to whoever I want to give it to. And I just think that's just how they see it. But she don't like being embarrassed with it. But she says, like even if that do be the case, what's the point of speaking on it out loud? That be the part that messed me up. Like, people not player no more at all. Like, people not player no more at all. Everything is publicized. All right. So basically, it seemed like she just have a problem with the girl speaking out about it. She's pretty much saying, girl, just be quiet. You don't have to go there. What was the point? All right. So she say, I got to stay prayed up. It's evil out here. Well, are they married? Are they married? I don't know. Do you think they ever going to get married? Little Baby's an open relationship. Jayda just don't know it yet. I think she knows it. She just don't like to be embarrassed. I think she's like a tiny. Don't you know how tiny? She knows T.I. goes around, but she just gets upset when people talk about it and it's embarrassing to her. You know, I think that's just the thing. Yeah. So let's keep on going here. Don't you get tired of Jayda already? She says, babe, I'm a woman first. I handle his behind on the back end, not the internet, all right? So people are saying, are you going to hold him accountable? She said, listen, what we go through is not for the internet. I'm going to handle it in the back end. But I think she's talking a little bit too much. I mean, for you to tell us that, Jayda, it lets us know you plan to talk to him about it. And it let us know that it is some truth with it because you believe it. And you let him know that you're going to check him. I think, Jayda, you should just not respond to these people and just ignore it and just let them cheat in peace and just keep on moving on because they say she not going to leave him. You know, I don't think, Jayda, do you think she's going to ever get away? I mean, get rid of all her Chanel bags, all her Balenciaga bags? Nope. I think her attachment is, you know, those accessories. And I think Lil Baby, he plays a major part of the biggest trophy amongst her Chanel bags, her Balenciaga bags, is to have the top rapper on her side. Is she married to him? No. Do he want to be a husband? I doubt it. That don't matter. What matters is he's the top tier in the rap industry. Now, if he was broke, if he ain't had no money, do you think she'll still be with him? Comment, let us know. Considering how Jayda, she's always, you know, she's very shallow. She's into designer clothes. She always, you know, money, 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 money. Do you think if Lil Baby, if he was not a popular rapper, and he didn't have much money, and his behavior was still the same, do you think that she would stay with him? You know, press 10 if you feel like she would still be with him if he was broke and he was not popular. Press 12 if you think she would not be with him, okay? Have to think about it. Press 12 if you think she would not be with him. Comment, let us know. When he take care of you and the bills, you don't have to work. But you know what? I think she's a millionaire herself. Like, she got her own money, you know? When you have your own money, you're not looking for a man to take care of your bills. I mean, some people do, but it's not like a definitely need to. Look at Fantasia. She's not looking for her husband to pay her bills, you know? Look at Monique. She's not looking for her husband to pay her bills either. But I don't know. What do y'all think? I think that if he was broke and he ain't had no money and he was not popular, it would not fit the Jayda brand. I think it would not fit the Jayda brand. All right, so let's keep on moving on. So this is Jayda after everything happened. And she wanted to let you guys know she is still in designer. She still got the expensive coats. She's still making money. She's still the baddest bee on the internet. You know, she was bragging about how good her business was going. So she's still good. And you know, the first thing these girls will tell you, like if you talk bad about Jayda, if you talk bad about Ari, or if you talk bad about Regina, the first thing they're going to say is, your man broke. They're going to say, at least I ain't messing with no broke man, you know? So let's keep on moving on. All right, so this is Ari's ex-best friend, all right? They call her Gigi, and you see it, Ari's ex-best friend. She got a message for Jayda. It says, just told for my man, I'm cheating on them. This for you, Jayda. Since you ain't a cheater, I'll be cheating for you. All right? So basically, she's saying, you know what? I know you ain't a cheater. I'm going to cheat for you. But I'm not understanding the first part. Just told four of my men. What? I just told four of my men. Okay. That threw me off. She forgot that. I just told. It was just told. Okay. Anyway, let's move on. Okay. So let's move on. So happy birthday to Nicki Minaj. I don't know if you guys know, but they are saying it's Nicki Minaj's birthday. And this is her mommy. And her mommy put pictures up. And it says, on this night, 38 years ago, I cherish every moment, for it would be the last night. You could hear my heart beat from the inside, and tomorrow would be the first day of me seeing my heart beat on the outside. The joy of being able to hold my baby girl took over, and I couldn't wait to meet you. I think you wanted to meet me too, because you became bright and early. All right? So happy birthday to Nicki Minaj. All right, so she got four men. Shit. All right, well, go ahead with your four men. All right. So happy birthday to Nicki Minaj, as you guys can see. Uh-huh. What y'all think about that? All right. All right, happy birthday to you, boo. So let's keep on going on. So the Neighborhood Talk decided to shout us out. All right. Thank you, Neighborhood Talk. You know, keep on doing what you're doing. You always got good hot tea, and I will forever be watching your blog. And I'm always on it 5 times a day because you be getting that goddamn tea. All right. So keep on bringing the hot tea, and I'm going to keep on looking for hot tea. All right. So let's move on. So like I said before, Ari is the Gretchen of the group. So this is what people are saying about Ari. You see her with Moneybag. They said they are only hope, all right? They said Ari and Moneybag is our only hope. People are saying y'all ain't got nobody else in y'all family y'all can look up to. And trust me, they just here for Ari. Moneybag is not that popular. Ari has a whole bunch of people that look up to her and worship her. And Ari is definitely seen as the meanest girl in the group. Like, she's always going to put paws on you. She always got something bad to say. Like, she is definitely the Gretchen of the group, okay? And Jayda, she's the Georgia. She's the, nah, hell, why do I get them all confused? Ari is the Georgina, and Gretchen is the Jayda. I swear to goddamn Georgina Gretchen. You know what? I'm not used to saying them goddamn names. I don't know nobody named Gretchen. And I don't know nobody named Georgina. Them names is so foreign to me. But anyway, let's keep on moving on. All right. So Nick Cannon is celebrating with his baby mama, Brittany. You know, so don't they look nice? So this is Brittany and Nick Cannon. All right. So they're showing you pictures of her belly. Now, can you guys let us know they together? What they plan on doing? Are they just friends? Mm-hmm. Congratulations to her. And I guess this is the baby. Can you see the kid? Look at the kid. You see the kid? They got him hanging upside down. All right. So let's keep on going here. So that's so cute. Mm-hmm. She started from home. Only Gretchen I know was on recess. All right. There we go. Uh-huh. Yep. The Gretchen I was talking about was from the Mean Girls, the movie, the Mean Girls. So let's keep on going. I guess I'll look in the comment section. They said Nick has a total of 3 kids. With one on the way, twins for Mariah, and this is his second with Brittany. Thanks. All right, coming to TED Talk. This man really be wilding out. It's the Nike suit for me. I'm honestly confused with him. One thing about Nick, he gonna He gone, a baby shower. All right, well, congratulations to Nick. Let's just move the hell on. So, I don't know who knew this, who did not know this. Did you guys know that Lil Wayne and Solange Knowles used to date? Did you guys know that? They are saying that Lil Wayne and Beyonce's sister used to hook up and date, and this is from Bow Wow. Why Bow Wow speaking out about this? I don't know. All right. People are saying I was today years old when I found out Solange and Lil Wayne dated. All right. Everybody knows Solange and Lil Wayne dated. No, we didn't. All right. So did you guys know that Lil Wayne and Solange used to date? Comment, let us know. And this is from Bow Wow. Do you think he lied? I don't know. So people are saying, in a weird way, this doesn't surprise me. I don't know why. But this made me think of when Solange was pregnant with Jules and did a cameo with the Soulja video with Lil Wayne. I'm not shocked he was able to bag Lauren London and get a whole baby out of her. Well, I don't know what y'all think, but Lil Wayne, he stayed with very attractive women. He got attractive women right now. You know, he stay having some fine girls. I don't think a lot of girls care about a lot of guys, how attractive they are. Shit, especially if they got money. Mm-mm. So let's keep on moving on. So this is the baby. He got some new pictures with Danny. Look at that. Look at that, him and Danny. And the baby mama, she not here for it. Nope. All right. So this is the baby mama. This is Mimi. That's what they call her. This is the baby mama. It's too many babies. I can't keep on seeing a baby in my mouth like that. But she says, y'all ever plotted on a man? Like, yeah, I'm going to get him. All right. So people are saying, girl, you need to let it go. So fighting for custody of the baby. Mm-mm-mm. In about 5.6 hours, Danny, too, will be writing the same message. Ain't nobody got the time to be doing the back and forth. I asked with Mimi. She just need to leave that baby alone. Y'all need to leave all the babies alone. Because you see, with Mimi and with Jayda, they both with babies, right? Now, their name is baby for a damn reason. And they keep on treating these girls like yo-yos. And Mimi keep on going back with the baby. Jayda keep on going back with little baby. Do you think they ever gonna change their ways? I doubt it. I doubt it. So now it's time for these girls to take accountability. And if you don't want to get treated like this, then just be done with it. But let's keep on moving on. So she passed last night, yesterday. You guys know her, right? Natalie. She played Babs, you know? She played on a TV show with Eve. Yeah, she passed away last night. I don't know how she went, but she got her wings. She definitely got her wings. Let's keep on moving on. So, Miss, this girl right here, she said she stopped saying the N-word because people kept on telling her, I don't feel comfortable with you because you mix saying the N-word. How do y'all feel about that? So she's speaking on her position. People are saying, well, this is what she said. She says, I am less black that someone half black. I'm all confused. I am less black than someone half black. I ain't never heard nobody say nothing like that. But also less white than someone half white. An Asian is the least thing I am. Shit. I thought she, well, you know what? I don't put no labels on nobody. Be who you want. I don't know what, I don't care. It says, so at this point, it's whatever they want me to be. Hey, I feel the same. Girl, I don't know what to tell you. What do you guys put her in? What do you guys think? All right, this tweet has been deleted. So she deleted this. Do you think that she has the right to say the N-word? Do you think she doesn't have the right to say the N-word? What y'all think? You know, do you give her permission to say the N-word? If you give her permission to say the N-word, press 20. If you feel like she should not be saying the N-word, press 25. I guess it's just saying, is she black enough? If she ain't black enough, I don't know. So anyway, let's keep on moving on. What the hell does this mean, mama? Yeah, I ain't get it either. I am less black than someone half black, but also less white. I don't get it. I don't know. Don't ask me to interpretate. It means I am whatever you say I am. I saw the argument that other people are more black than me. Damn. Is it a race to be black? Because they are half and half. So I'm just saying, they are also more of the other race than me. I don't know. Is it a race to be black? I don't know. But clearly she feels some type of way about it. I stopped out of consideration to the people who are offended and who thought I was not in a position to say it. Okay? I wasn't confused, though. I am your reflection. All right? All right, so she just going back and forth. I don't know what to put it as. It says, not just Twitter, but would be surprised where I come from. My friends consider my family black because they see my black father, black grandparents, black siblings. I also stopped out of respect for my ancestors that I know suffered greatly. Being, oh, shoot, I'm with you with that. She said she also stopped saying the N-word because her black ancestor suffered from that word, so she's not going to use that word. I feel you on that, boo. Okay? All right. All right, so this is her DNA. She want to let you guys know. I guess it's Japan. She got some England in her. She got some Africa, some Spain. She got some everything, you know? She got some everything. All right, so people are saying 32% black African roots. She also from everywhere. She too deep and unproblematic. Leave her alone. She don't bother nobody. We won't tolerate her slander. Okay, off topic, but her skin is gorgeous. Leave her alone. So people pretty much say, leave this girl alone, you know? She's a good girl. She's unproblematic. You know, leave her alone. You need 1%. Well, she got 25%. So, no, she got 13%. I don't know what percent she got. Shit. She got something. All right. So, people were talking about this couple. You guys know she's, you know, very powerful, athletic girl. What her name is, Simone. And this is her boyfriend. But people had a problem. They said, we live, she says, people are saying, why on his posts? Because, you know, he got an Instagram, too. Why we never see you on his posts, but every time you turn around, you always posting him on your Instagram. She says, we live together. He doesn't need to post me, all right? So she said, we live together. You don't need to post me, all right? What y'all think about that? So we go back here, and she posts some more pictures of her boyfriend. Simone, this is on her Instagram. She said, the world's best girlfriend award goes to me, but may need more friends. I'm going to lose him. Nah, all right? So basically, she's saying, listen, I just bought him a game system. And the best girlfriend award goes to her because of it. And she feels that she's going to lose him now because he's going to spend all that time playing a game. And he's not going to pay her ass attention. Of course, she's joking. I don't think she means it. But people are taking it a different way. They say it's one thing about Simone. She's always going to have a fine man next to her. All right. If a game system make you the best girlfriend, then I don't want it. All right. Somehow every celebrity can get their hands on a game system. All right. So, well, congratulations, boo. I hope you're happy with them. And I hope it lasts forever. That's all I gotta say. We need better representation. Women need to be strong-minded again. She is biracial. Talking about the other girl. Here we go with this. So you guys know that Ray J and Princess are still in the process of getting divorced, sources told, all right? But you know what, Princess? I told you, girl. I told you when we was up in Vegas, I said, leave Ray J alone. He's a dog. He's been cheating on you. And everybody keep on saying she ain't going to leave him because she's stuck on money. You allowed him back in. He did you wrong. You got rid of him. Then you allowed him back in. You see, he know he can come back whenever, you know, because you don't have standards for yourself. Wear your own boundaries, letting people know you don't, they're not going to treat you any type of way. They're not going to keep lying to you. But fast forward, he is messing around with his co-worker. Not his co-workers, but the girls that work for him. So I don't know if you guys know, but the Bad Girls Club, he was supposed to be producing it, right? He's helping produce the Bad Girls Club. So these are videos of him and Sierra. Let me put this up.
Instagram ain't like you, anyways.
Oh man, I gotta do a reunion, man, in like a week or two.
Get me out the way.
You know what I'm saying?
Hell no!
What you mean,
fucking
you
know what
I'm saying?
It's a checklist. Like, fire OG.
Checklist.
You ain't got fire OG? Cookies. Wait, hold on, I'm talking.
Girl, you hear all that cussing in the background? That's why. Thank you, Shay Room, for bleeping that out. But look at her. She love it. She, look at her. Look at her. Look at her face. She is loving all this attention from Ray J. She feel like she's somebody. She feel like she can sit on the throne next to Princess. Yeah, girl. She feel like she's on Princess level. I bet she feeling like, yeah, I took, you know. Uh-huh. Because we ain't never seen Ray J linked up with a girl. We always heard. But this the first time he went public with the girl, and he seemed like he's bold with this too. Look at him. He all in the video. You know, she's trying to say, you know we on video. He's kissing on her, you know? And Princess got to see this, and his kids got to see this, how he treating it. Girl, this is too damn disrespectful. I know Princess mad. A goddamn Sarah from Bad Girls Club. That don't got a pot to piss in. And you gonna do this. I mean, at least get somebody that's on her same level or respectable or something. I don't know. I would never see Princess and this Sarah girl on the same damn level. Yeah, they work together. Yeah, and I just said, he's taking advantage, putting his thing in all these girls he work with. You know, or work for him, you know. I hope these girls don't feel peer pressured. He probably wanted to make another video. Don't you know them Kim K videos he got? He probably want to make a video. But you would think he's at an age where he wouldn't want to be seen like this. He would be take his life more mature. I think this is a slap in the face to Princess. I really do. What y'all think about it? What do y'all think about it? Do you think it's a slap in the face to Princess? If you feel like it is, press 30. Could you, and if you feel like it ain't, press 35. Could you imagine if you and your husband in the process of getting divorced, he always cheated on you and you forgave him time and time again, and then he gonna be so bold in the process of y'all getting divorced and get on video with girls he work with, kissing on them all on video, being so bold about it. And Princess, she knew your butt was a dog, because remember she kept on saying, I feel like he is messing around with his assistants. I feel like he is messing around with his coworkers. And she didn't trust how he was all up in the hours. And what'd he say? Nah, baby, it's not like that. You know, she's so insecure. She got to learn how to trust me. I have female assistants and they help me out. Well, look how you do, man. You up here messing and kissing around girls that work for you. He definitely. Princess, an ex-stripper. Now, I ain't know she was no ex-stripper. But it looked like she changed her life around. That dated Money Mayweather, who was friends with Ray J at the times. Still friends with him. Well, if you know what? If Princess used to be a stripper hoe, she have turned herself around. Can I ask y'all a question? Do you think Princess have changed her stripper hoe ways? If you think Princess had changed her stripper hoe ways, press 40. If you feel like she's still a stripper hoe deep inside, press 45. You know, I've never heard this girl cheating on Ray J, embarrassing him, doing him wrong. I feel like she don't got that stripper hoe spirit inside of her anymore. Maybe she had the stripper hoe spirit a long time ago. I think she got delivered, and maybe she is saved and sanctified, and she really wanted the marriage. I honestly feel like she really wanted the marriage, and maybe because she had that stripper hoe spirit, maybe that allowed her to have low self-esteem, and, you know, some of the girls feel like, well, you know, he's a good man, and if he did cheat a little bit, I don't want people to judge me so harshly, you know, for what I did in my past. I deserve it. I deserve it because I was a stripper hoe in my past. So this is what I deserve. Some people feel like that, but you don't deserve it, boo. You don't deserve it. I used to strip, wasn't me. And I guess what? Every girl that was a stripper didn't have a stripper hoe spirit, you know? Some people, you know, they like to do it because they like to explore their body. They're very artistic. Shit, who knows? I was just watching some movie on Stars. It's called Flesh and Bones, and it was this girl in a strip club. Have y'all ever seen a TV series? It's called Flesh and Bones on Stars, and about this ballerina girl, and she gets involved in a strip club. But yeah, she wasn't a hoe, but she was stripping. But let's keep on moving here. Not the stripper spirit. Well, some of y'all got the damn stripper spirit, you know? When certain music want to come on, next thing you want to know, you want to act like you're a stripper. You want to get on a pole. You want to do all this freaky, kinky shit. So anyway, Cardi B, she's still on it. She still ain't learned, you know? She broke up with his... took her out being a stripper. So it says, so do y'all want me to show y'all the purse? Remember that purse she was going to spend $88,000 on? And then she came out talking about she apologized. Girl, they said she's still on it. They said she is still on it and she's going to show y'all the purse. So this is the purse that she was going to pay. I guess she paid it. It says this is the purse she's crying about. She wants $88,000 for it. I don't know who she is. But this is the purse. Yes, Exotic Dancers. Yeah, she left Floyd for Ray. I'm an ex-stripper proud. Come on, ex-strippers. Let me tell you. I got a best friend that used to strip, okay? I got cousins that used to strip. Can I tell you something else? It's some strippers on YouTube. I follow their stripping channel. Yeah, it's some girls on YouTube, and they give you video logs of their day-to-day in the strip industry. And I follow, and I look at them. Yeah, I support the stripper girls. So do you guys think this purse is worth $88,000? Do y'all think it's worth $88,000? All right, some people say they about to be a stripper. All right, go ahead. If I were you, I'd take some ballet classes first, you know, so you can have some stretch or something. Okay. What y'all think about this? So let's keep on going here. It says, girl, I could have made you that for $88. Girl could find something identical at Macy's. You know what, Cardi? If you want to be honest, I think I seen that at Walmart like a year ago. Yeah, I think I seen that purse at the Walmart. Mm-hmm. I don't know if y'all know, but Walmart got some nice purse selections. Do y'all ever go? I know a lot of y'all are too bougie to go to Walmart. Mm-hmm. But Walmart got a nice little purse connection. Oh, TJ Maxx, you sure right. You got Marshalls. You got Burlington Coat Factory. Mm-hmm. And they got some deals, girl. Yes, they do. Or guess who else got some cute purses and they be very affordable? Victoria's Secret. Do you ever go shop at Victoria's Secret? Go to Victoria's Secret and look at their purses. They have some nice, affordable purses at Victoria's Secret. Yes, they do. Mm-hmm. Target. Mm. I don't know if it's a Birkin bag, but let's keep on moving on.
Now, I'll be remiss if I did not mention this biopic that you guys are supposed to be coming out with. What is going on? Tell me.
Well, we've been in talks, you know, all of us, all four girls, we are ready for this to happen. We're making sure that the people that are getting involved is who we want to be involved with this, because when you do a life story, that's it. You know, you can't go back and change anything. You can't go erase anything. So we just want to make sure that it's done right. We've already kind of talked about who we want to play the roles of each and every one of us. I know Tiny talked about Zanique playing her in the movie. Yes. And then my sister wants my niece, Tanaya, to play her because, you know, they both act like they're just alike, both of them. Candy said she wanted, I forgot the young lady's name. It slipped my mind. But Notori, Notori from the show Power.
Yeah.
But everybody's like, oh my gosh, you guys look alike. You know, it's been, and plus she can sing. And I talked to her at BET, her, when we had to perform that night. And she was like, I would love to. So we're kind of just making sure the people who we bring in to play us really does the, you know, will do the part. And so, and then just trying to make sure, because all the stuff is going on, that we will be able to film, you know, because we do want to be in the film as well, as what we're talking about doing. So yeah, that's what's the
okay. So at the
but we
end,
are still doing it, you guys. So yeah, it's still
thank
important.
You, thank you. It is definitely needed. We definitely want to hear. Now I'll be remiss if I did not mention this biopic that you guys are supposed to be coming out with. What is going on? Tell me.
Well, we've been in talks. You know, all of us, all four girls, we are.
All right, so you guys excited for the biopic? You know, they say Tiny is trying to get her daughter to play her. I don't think that's a good idea, you know? All right, and Notori, she's going to play the girl that you see on the screen. I don't know, I feel like somebody that should play Tiny should be an actress. I don't think I've never seen Zanique act before, and I don't want it to be her debut. And Notoria, she's 5 foot, right? Tiny, she's 4'11". I ain't trying to, I don't got nothing against her, you know, but I think Tiny should be short, you know, I think she should be small, considering her name, because Zanique is tall. She's 5'7", you know, and Tiny in real life, Tiny is 4'11". That's like 7-8 inches taller, and you're going to have Zanique, she's 5'7", Notori 5 foot, and then you have other short girls, you know. Tiny, nah, you need to get a professional actress that's small. I think small, but I understand she want her daughter to have more gigs and stuff, you know, but nah, I ain't for that one. But anyway, let's keep on moving on. So they are saying that Future is out here giving girls money to have, you know, to get rid of the seeds. You know what I mean? The A word. So basically, Future's, I think he forces his choices on girls to get pregnant. I don't think he's pro-choice. I think he forces his choice on girls. So this is a clip of Future. And he says, last thing you need to worry about is money. You showing you can't be trusted. Friday, no excuses. So basically, he's saying you are showing. It's no, you not to be trusted because you're showing. You're showing that you're pregnant. And he said, Friday, go take care of it. No excuses. So he is forced choice. He forces his choices on you. Because we don't know if this girl, you know, she probably do want to have this baby. Who knows? You know, it's not all about him sometimes. So what y'all think about this? So this is what the article reads up here. Future alleged got 11th woman pregnant, offers 20K for the A word. You know what I mean? All right. So what do y'all think about this? And this definitely came from Gossip in the City. Future falling for future bullcrap. More gigs, not with the crappy music. All right, so I'm going to keep on going here. All right, so do you guys remember this girl? So this is Floyd Mayweather's daughter at the end. Her name is Jayda. Now, she's pregnant with NBA Youngboy, right? Now, the girl in the middle, allegedly, she was pregnant with NBA Young Baby. But she lost it when Yaya was slicing and dicing her arm, right? So now the girl in the middle who got her arm sliced and diced by Yaya, she is speaking out. And she got some things she got to say. So let's look at what she got to say. She says, I feel like I'm going back in that stage to where I want to give up. Fix it, Jesus. And this was November the 30th, 2020. So she feels like she's losing all hope, you know. She want to give up. She says, sometimes I just sit with my eyes closed, try to pull it together. I don't say anything because it's like I can't get nothing out when I have too much to talk about, all right? So she just all lost. She got so much to say, but she can't get it all out because she got so much stuff she want to say, but she don't know how to say it. She says, I got to go through this pain alone. Pretty much letting us know that NBA young boy, he's not there for her. Nobody's there for her. You know, NBA young boy, he got a new girlfriend that he's concerned with now. He's not concerned with her. All I do is shake my head. Sometimes I cry. She's heartbroken. All right. So she said, all I do is shake my head, y'all. She said, nobody better not tell me how to feel or what to do because I have to look at my arm every day. I have to look at what Yaya Mayweather did to my arm every single day. And I don't think she's going to press charge. I don't know what she's doing. Can y'all let me know what she's doing? Is she pressing charges? Is Yaya going to the big house? What's really going on with this situation? Because I'm all lost, all right? So in here, it says, all right, they cussing a lot over there. So what do y'all think about this? Comment, let us know. So they chopped her arm off, and she just got to sit there through the pain, basically. Basically, that's what's going on. Trial is coming. All right. People are saying the trial is coming. So we just have to see. They still have to go to court. Stop posting stuff on social media. If you don't want people in your business, well, you know what? I guess some people don't have nobody to talk to. They don't have nobody to express how they truly feel. They may not have any fans or family. So they go to their fan base and they express themselves, you know? Because a lot of people, y'all may think it's strange, but a lot of people rather talk to strangers on social media about their business than talk to their family members or talk to their friends. Yeah, people would rather feel more comfortable telling their secrets to social media than their family and their friends. I'm telling you. But comment, let us know what y'all think about this. We started off with here. It is some videos, if you just getting in, girl, the videos is horrible, okay? Of Max putting a pause on Brandi. Brandi and Max, yeah. All right, so do you guys want me to play my version real quick? I can play my version last time. It's right here before we leave out of here. Bam, bam. All right, so here it is. I had to cut some stuff out because he cussed a lot on there. So check this out.
Say yeah, I got it. Say yeah, I got it, bitch, you got it. I shall fucking come ass. Who f***ing nigga bitch that you just want to ask? How the f*** you want to ask with? I'm not down for it. Fuck you. I'm fucking going away. You got that thing on my head yet? You got that thing on your head yet?
Girl, I can't stand it. Okay, so he's grabbing her by the head, right? Pushing her face down where she can't even talk, all right? And he's saying, I'm not down with your program. You got that through your thick head, B? You got that through your head, B? Keep on calling her B, a female dog, all right? Yeah, but tomorrow he gonna say, I love you. You know, I ain't mean to do that, girl. This been going on. This has been going on. He's been putting her on that show to be so aggressive and loud and crazy. Yeah, that's the act that they want her to play. And she, you know, she needs help her damn self. You know what I mean? Because clearly she has low self-esteem. And guess what? After all this, she gonna... All right, some people say you can barely hear him. Now this is the other version right here. Maybe you can hear him clear on here. Check this out. If I can move it here.
Got it? Say yeah, I got it. Say yeah, I got it. Say yeah, I got it if you got it, bitch. I ain't your motherfucking clumsy ass, goofy ass nigga, bitch, that you just wanna act how the fuck you wanna act with. I'm not down for it, bitch. Fuck you, and fuck that boy right here. You got that through your motherfucking head yet? You got that through your head yet? You got that through your head, bitch? I'm not with your program. Fuck off with me. Be out of here, bitch.
Now try me, I'll stick your feet on me. You won't have to see me ever again. I promise you,
never again will you stick my feet on.
Bye, bitch. Goodbye. Good motherfucking bye. You're gonna start fucking with me. Ronnie, don't call me. I'm getting beat up. You gonna disrespect me to Ronnie too, bitch? You think you're gonna disrespect me to the world, Brandi? Is that what you think? You're not! You're not!
Call
911,
Brandon.
You're not! Bitch! Ladies, you're not!
Call 911, your sister just got hit in her lips.
Call me self, bitch. I'm about to fuck you up, bitch. Ronnie, I'm getting beat up, bitch. Oh, bitch, I'm gonna send you out on a good one, bitch.
Girl, it's too much, too much. Anyway, you know, it's more video you gotta check out in the beginning. You know, I'm gonna leave it out here. They say that she getting, that Max been doing this to her for over 17 years. Everybody know about it. Ray J know he put the balls on her. Everybody in Hollywood know she gets dogged out by him. It's nothing new. You know, so I just pray for her. They say that he got her phone. He's putting out text messages on social media. You know, she came out with this, but people are saying he put this out here. And you guys can read this while I put the music on. All right, I'm going to put the music on, and I'll see y'all sooner than later. DJ, please pump that beat.